Hey everyone, I am so excited we are on. So let's give it just a second to let all of you get on. So I'm excited because we are finishing up 2017 and getting ready to start 2018. And so I wanted to create a series called Customers, and we're going to have different topics about them. So today we're going to cover customers, where to find them. And then we're going to have different things on how to get paid, events and fundraisers and samples and follow-up. So a lot of different things that we really want to do with our customers and how we can really bring more customers to us and even reach out to new customers. So today is going to be about customers and where to find them. And not sure if you know, but we do have an Avon Memory Jogger. And I'm going to put this on our naturallybeautifultips.com page, and it will be in the free resource section. So definitely check out the website. And I want to give you a few things of what you want to do. So with this memory jogger, what we also have is a contact list. And I know you hear me talk about the contact list a lot. And this is very important when you are wanting to grow this business, whether you're wanting to make just a couple hundred dollars or you're wanting to make thousands of dollars. Okay, so you really want to invest in this contact list and really keep it up to date and rotate people in and out, because you're going to find customers who come in and buy from you, but then for some reason they stop. Maybe their sister starts selling or something like that. And so you're going to have customers who will come and go. And then you'll have those great customers who definitely stays with you because you gave them that great customer service. And now they are your customers forever. So let's talk about where would you find customers. So let's think about our family, our uncles, our aunts, sisters, our brothers, our sister-in-laws, our brother-in-laws, grandparents, in-laws. There's a huge range of just family that you can really think about when you're in this business. The other people that you want to think about is your friends. So who do you know? Who were your high school friends? Who were your college friends? Who were your coworkers that are friends? Coworkers open up another area, your church family and friends. So really think about how you can do that. And just in those few categories that I just mentioned, there's a lot of people that you can fill up this contact list with. So again, more people, who do you know? So your bank tellers, your children's friends, parents, flight attendants, mail carrier, your neighbor, people you grew up with, like I said, your high school friends or even elementary friends, teammates. So if you were on a sport, who do you know? I'm sure you're still buddies with a lot of them. And then who do you know on Facebook, Google Plus, Instagram, LinkedIn, Pinterest, Tumblr, Twitter, Snapchat? Oh my gosh, there's so many social media sites that I'm sure that you're on a lot. So who do you know that's on social media sites? And then people who you see on a regular basis are throughout the year. So you have your accountant, you have the appraiser, you have your babysitter, you have the cashier where you go and eat dinner or maybe grab lunch real quick. What about the cashier at the gas station? So for years, I used the same gas station, and every day I was in there. So I made sure when I started this business almost 11 years ago, that is who I went to. I went to people that I knew and who knew me. So you really want to think about that. Okay, so what about your hairdresser? So you're always going to get pretty, or maybe your barber. I know we've got some guys on here. So really think about who cuts your hair, who does those things for you, maybe highlight your hair. So you really want to go back to them and give them a brochure and let them know you have this Avon business now. What about the nurse, the doctor? Especially with us having children, we're always at the doctor's offices or dentist's offices. So really think about how you can spread your business and talk with those people that you're going to see throughout the year anyway. So I've heard one top leader say, well, if they get my money, I want to get some of their money. So you're providing business for them. So let them help you keep your business open by buying Avon from you. But you have to make sure you give them the brochure or you give them your website. So just depending on how they want to shop and how you want to do it as well. So if you're on, it does not show me, like I said before, on here. So definitely comment. I would love to know who is on and watching. What are your opinions about customers? Where do you find your customers? So that is really big. So one place that I might think of looking, I might not think of another location, but you have. So where do you find your customers? So let's talk about some more categories. So who do you know at bowling, camp, childcare, the hardware store, the health club, a hotel, library? So I know a lot of us do homeschool or even public school, and even with public school, you still got to go to your local library. So who can you talk to there to give a brochure to? So lots and lots of places. Who sells you your mortgage? Who sells the cabinets, bridal gown, your vehicle? So really think about every place, everywhere you go, and everyone you know. You really can give them that Avon brochure and open that business up to them and let them know. And then on your contact list, this is very important. So on your contact list, you really want to put their name, their phone number, their email. If you don't have a lot of time, those are the three things that you want to get. But we're going to talk about how to really invest in your customers long-term and activities that's going to help you grow even more. So you really want to get their address. So again, if you don't have a lot of time or you are in that checkout line, just get their name, phone number, and email, and then you can always reach back out to them when they're off of work and not getting in trouble, because we don't want them to do that. But then you can reach out to them and get their address for future brochures to be sent to them or dropped off to them. So that is another thing that you want to do. And then preferred contact method. So I have my phone, and a lot of my customers really like to have text message. They are great with me sending a text reminder of when my orders go in, and that works for me and that works for them. And so that's what I do for a lot of my customers. But then I still have some of those customers that I still pick up my house phone for. So I know not everyone has a house phone anymore, but you can pick up your cell phone and you really want to call and very simple. Hey, this is Arlena with Avon. I just wanted to let you know that I'm placing an order in a couple of days and wanted to see if you needed anything. And literally that phrase right there is what I did. And that's how I grew to over $22,000 in my first year with Avon. And even with me stepping back a little bit with my customers and going out and getting new customers every day like I was in the past, now I'm working more with you. But even with me doing that, again, when you build up your customer list and you have this contact list solid and you can still bring new people in, you're going to have where those customers are going to call you, they're going to message you, they're going to stay with you. And even this year, I still sold over 22,000 helping my team members. So you really want to work on building your customer list. So today, what we're talking about is where to find them. So I am, again, going to put the memory jogger along with the contact list. And I have two different contact lists that you can pull. So either one that you want to do, but pull them from our naturallybeautifultips.com page. And it's under the free resource. So it will be up in just a minute. Let me know what you think. How many places do you go to that you can give a brochure to? So comment that, let me know. And I can't wait to see how many customers are going to be on your contact list. keep this up to date. So as you get new customers every campaign, you can always come back to this video and say, I've got 5 new customers and now I'm up to 20 customers, or I'm up to 10 customers. Or eventually you're going to say, I'm up to 100 customers or 125 customers. So I have really grew my customer base and now I have over 1,000 customers, and I'm looking at 2018 on how I can be more productive and beneficial to them as their Avon representative. So really think about that, because of course I don't have 1,000 customers ordering every campaign. And so I'm putting things into place and I really want to help y'all do the same. So this is the first series of customers, where to find them. And throughout the week, over the next few weeks, we will bring out more videos about customers and different topics related to them. And I will definitely have this on my YouTube channel, so you'll be able to watch it there. So y'all have a good day and can't wait to see how you grow in 2018.